Moving to another culture, another country, can be a wrench, especially when that move is permanent, when you decide to live there. So imagine, if you're Japanese moving to the UK, how do you stave off the homesickness? Well, I suppose you could listen to lots of Japanese music on a Japanese stereo. You could get your husband to dress up as a samurai warrior, or you could build yourself a permanent living testament to your homeland, something you can enjoy every day. You could build yourself a state-of-the-art Japanese home. Subarashi daro. Japan is a land of intrigue and mystery that has captured the imagination of the West for centuries. It captivated Professor of Experimental Physics Nigel Hussey, who met his wife Tamayo here 16 years ago.
I was working in Tokyo and I was invited to a party. Met my friends there, and just as they opened the doors to the party, I saw Tamayo there dancing. But at that moment, I kind of plotted her downfall.
I'm not sure that's a good way to describe it in that way.
An hour out of Tokyo is this small town, set in a blue plum and cherry tree forest.
Hi, konnichiwa.
It's here that Tamayo grew up in a traditional Japanese home, the style of which she and Nigel would like to reproduce in Britain.
It's all made of wood and paper. It's a very fragile and very delicate. So simple too.
That's partly because in an earthquake-prone country, it makes sense to build with lightweight materials. Many houses in Japan are only expected to last 20 years or so, but still, great pride and care is taken in making them. The key elements are tatami, or straw mats, fusama, or sliding doors, and ornamental room dividers, or rama.
I think for a Japanese person, the integrity of the house is in the interior, where they really take a lot of effort to get the detailing right, the finishes on the corners, the clean lines, everything about the interior, and it's also relationship to the outside are what excite us about Japanese architecture.
When they left Japan 14 years ago, they decided to live somewhere that would remind them of Tamayo's hometown. And so they moved to Wales. It was in the Wye Valley in the Welsh borders that they found a plot for £375,000. I say plot, it was a house, a simple, damp dwelling that they felt they could improve on for them and their son. It was cold, miserable, and poorly built with small windows. How could they not improve on that?
What are your ambitions for this place?
We're building a very contemporary house, but with rather traditional Japanese elements. There's going to be a single room downstairs with sliding doors, and on the top floor, a Japanese bathhouse, which has an outdoor bath.
Wow. What are you going to do here? Does this go completely?
I call it a decapitation of the house. We're cutting off this big roof and building upwards into the canopy.
It's not going to look like, you know, an adapted brick-built chalet.
No. Well, that is not the aspiration here.
Nigel and Tamayo's true ambition is to bring Japan to Wales and build a Japanese-influenced home for their family. In true samurai fashion, they're going to behead their old masonry house but keep the first floor and walls to save some money. On top of this, they'll build the house up out of timber panels in Welsh-grown Japanese larch wood, adding two stories. The whole thing then gets a wrap of insulation and more Japanese larch cladding, transforming it into a 21st century woodland home. Inside, the traditional arrangement of pokey small rooms disappears. Instead, they'll install large windows throughout and a much more open plan arrangement with a well-lit kitchen and dining area facing east.
To one side of the living area, Nigel and Tamaya will construct the heart of this home, a Japanese tatami room, fitted with all the authentic features that Tamaya will recognize: paper sliding doors and straw mats. On the first floor, there'll be four bedrooms, one bathroom, and a small roof deck. The second floor will be home to the other big Japanese idea in the building, a large roof terrace fitted with a traditional outdoor wooden bath, along with a Japanese shower room and study. The design is for a wooden woodland box of a house, suited to its setting, unlike the house they've got at the moment.
The brick house doesn't work in forest for me. I think our design works far more better with cladding.
I'm going to try and use a timber that's not actually been used before for a domestic property in the UK.
Which is?
Japanese larch.
Japanese larch is lightweight and hard-wearing. It grows in the UK, but its high silica content means it blunts saw blades and it's tricky to mill. Its poor reputation means that our construction industry's forgotten about larch in Britain. So Nigel and Tamayo are setting a brave and experimental example here.
It's not common in this country yet to use Japanese larch for timber frame or cladding, but why not?
Yeah. Is it as durable as the European larches?
Durability is not an issue. Strength might be an issue.
And you want to use it structurally as well? Haven't you?
We're going to use it for both the timber frame and for the cladding.
So are you doing this because you miss home or because you miss Japan? Which is it?
Sort of both, maybe. Yeah? Yes.
So how much is it going to cost you to do this?
We have a budget, including everything, of about £175,000.
OK. And who's come up with that? Is that your architect or a quantity surveyor or a...
That's what I came up with, because that's what we can afford.
OK. Mm.
Our architect at the time said, you can't do it for that.
Your architect said that? Normally, they're incredibly optimistic.
We actually had to part company at the point of our budgets diverging.
Yeah, yeah. Mm. But you're still using the detailed drawings in
full? We only had the planning drawings.
OK.
I can't quite believe they're taking on a project this complicated without an architect. Not only that, the early costs for the project were £326,000. They've got roughly half that. To save money, they're doing as much as they can themselves.
We're essentially project managing and doing the financial management of this project.
OK, yeah. Mm. With experience of doing that before, is that something you've...
No.
No.
I've built kitchen cabinets before. Does that count?
No. There aren't that many people who kind of go into a project management and construction having costed it themselves and then having not built before and, you know, taking the whole thing on. That is right out there.
If that weren't extreme enough, they've got to live in a mobile home on site until they finish, which will hopefully be 9 months from now.